Hi, in this video, we're going to learn how to build a basic financial model in Microsoft Excel 2016. We're going to focus on the P&L, or income statement, in this video. So the first thing you want to do when you're starting to build a financial model is have a part of the model where you store all of your assumptions. And let's say that we have 2016, 2017, 2018. And maybe we're selling, let's say, chairs. So you're gonna have revenue assumptions. So let's first say revenue, cost of goods sold, and then operating expenses. So we're gonna have assumptions for each one of these things. So to keep it very basic, let's say we have units and price for our revenue. And so we're a chair business. Let's say we sell 100 units, and then 180, and then 350. One thing that you always want to do, no matter what, when you're modeling in Excel, is to format your assumptions as a nice dark blue. So if we go to the color section, I like to choose my own custom color, and under more colors, something like this, a nice bright blue. And the reason we do blue is because when someone else looks at a model, if your assumptions are blue, then it's very, very easy to tweak the model and to test the model's assumptions and say, okay, what if our units are 500 in this year, or 100? And it makes it easier to understand and faster to navigate. And when you don't have assumptions, you want to keep them black. So here's our revenue model price. Let's say we have $250 a chair. Here I will apply the accounting number format and then just decrease the decimals. You can see I'm not using the mouse. I think the mouse really, really slows you down in Microsoft Excel, so I try to avoid it. Next we have cost of goods sold. We already know how many units, so our, let's say, unit cost, or maybe manufacturing cost, let's say it's $150 per chair. In the interest of saving time, I'll just copy this to copy the format and then type 150. So I move that across, and the way that I did that was I pressed Control C, then I held down Shift and hit the right arrow twice, and then I pressed Control V, so that was copy paste. I'll delete this row, and this will allow us to build the income statement down to the gross margin. So that's revenue minus costs. Next, we'll have our operating expenses. Let's say we have payroll and or labor. Maybe we're outsourcing this and the labor costs us $10,000 a year. $10,000 a year. And let's make sure to actually apply the same type of format. $10,000 a year, maybe this is $15,000 a year, and $20,000 a year. Okay, and then maybe marketing costs, maybe this is $5,000 a year, $6,000 a year, $7,000 a year. Okay, so once you've built your assumptions, you're ready to actually start modeling. And to start modeling, what I'm going to do here is I will go to View and Freeze Panes. So I'll move the whatever header I want on the very top row to the top row by scrolling down, and I'll freeze panes. And freezing panes will lock the top left corner of your active cell when you click freeze panes. So you'll see that everything above or to the left of this active cell is now frozen. So as I scroll around, I can still see which fiscal year I'm in. So that's really helpful. And maybe I'll move this assumptions piece down below. So now that I'm here, I'll start the income statement. So let's start with net revenue. So net revenue is pretty easy. So an equal sign will multiply units times price, and you can see that it's just grabbed the format for us. So we have net revenue and then Cost of goods sold, COGS, the acronym. So we'll multiply units times the asterisk, unit cost. And then copy C, control C, and then drag it over. And now we have our gross margin, or gross profit, as we could say. And so that will be our revenue minus our direct costs, which are our cost of goods sold. And what I'll usually do here in things like gross profit, I'll put a GP percent, something like that, underneath so you can see exactly what the margin is. So I'll divide gross profit by revenue, go to the home tab, make sure that you're using a percent number format. And so we can see that our gross profit is exactly flat, which is what we would expect in our assumptions because our price and our unit costs are staying the same. Next, we have our operating expenses, and we have two pieces, and I'll just link them in from the assumptions up below, up above labor and marketing. And to make it a bit easier to see, I'll go to the home tab and I will increase indent so that they're kind of out to the side so you can see their subgroups of operating expenses. We grab labor here, and you can just copy it all down because it's in the same number of cells. You have six cells and six cells. And now ultimately we have is operating income, or earnings before interest and taxes, or EBIT. Many different words for the exact same thing. Whenever actually I have multiple costs, I'm going to insert a row here and I'll create a total just so you can see, and I will decrease the indent. Maybe put a little bottom border here, and I'll put a subtotal just so you can see what our total operating expenses are. And then your operating income is your gross profit minus your operating expenses. So, this business sucks until the third year. And we'll do kind of the same thing. So maybe we'll say operating margin. Percent. So that's easy enough. Now we have this, your operating income, and you, in order to calculate a margin, what you have to do is you take your profit and you divide it by the revenue, always. So now if we apply a percent to it, we have our operating income all the way down. If you wanted to go one step further, we could have taxes. So we would have to add a tax assumption up above. So if we want to go back into our assumptions piece, maybe we insert a couple more rows and we add a tax assumption, because we need a tax assumption to get us to net income. So let's say the tax rate is 40%. Oh, that's not showing up as the correct format. 40% each year. Now we can go down, and it's quite easy. We take our operating income, except here our operating income is negative, so you don't pay any taxes on that. But if your operating income is positive, let's not worry about a tax loss carry forward here. Let's say that you have your 40%, and then you have your operating income, and then ultimately you get your net income. And so if I'm coming in and I'm inheriting this financial model here, it's very easy for me to play with it. I can see basically all of the important metrics, which are gross profit, revenue, operating income, net income. And then if I want to, I can say, okay, here's my P&L. How can we change this business? What if we bring our unit costs down to 140 and then 130? And if you don't label the model correctly, it's very, very difficult to tweak things. And in business, very frequently you're changing assumptions, you're tweaking, you're constantly rebuilding. So you want flexible, easy models that are formatted in this way. And these are industry standard formats. So you want to keep your larger numbers with zero, with no decimals, and your assumptions in blue. All right, well, if you'd like to learn more, I have a Udemy course covering advanced modeling topics. It's called How to Become an Excel Power User in 2.5 Hours. You'll learn things like learning how to use Excel completely without the mouse to boost your speed. There's a link in the course details, and thanks for your attention.